coming to the genre in your cinema, whether it's Kaatru Veliyidai or most other films, there is this, you tend to gravitate towards a kind of a relationship drama. So I was wondering if there's, inside Mani Ratnam, there's this desire to do like a hardcore action film or a spy thriller or a full-length comedy or something like that.
Yeah. Full-length comedy, maybe not.
Okay.
But yeah, I mean, I love action. I've always loved action, always wanted to do. And I've managed, in every film that I had an opportunity to do action, I've tried to, no, I really enjoy it. It's really something which, you know, gives you a high. You know, you're grown up. I mean, cinema is meant for action, you feel. You know.
Right.
Action films are big films. You need to get the plot right. You need to get the casting right. You need to get... The closest I've come to both towards action and towards comedy is Thrida.
Okay.
And because it didn't become as big as we expected it, I think we've held it back.
Is there a genre that you would not touch, like maybe horror or something?
Yeah,
like?
I will not touch horror because I don't think I'm good at it. I'd watch and not make it.
Not make it, okay. How do you deal with the writing blocks? You're not able to crack a scene. How do you...
That happens very often, so it's not very difficult. I've been doing it for several years.
Right.
When I get stuck on a scene, I leave it, come outside, sit with the assistant directors and start wondering what title can we have for this film. You know, I mean, that's the easiest thing to do. It can take care of the whole day battling about the title or talk about the casting of the film. Whom shall we cast for this role? So that can occupy you and you feel that you're doing something important, but basically you're avoiding going back and writing that scene.
Is there any film that did not have a title to the very last minute?
Probably Yuva did not have a title for a very, very long time.
Yuva and Aidharith?
Yeah.
Okay.
Aidharith we had, but we didn't know whether it was gimmicky or not, so we waited.
But you stay within the film. You don't say, okay, let me try, I'll work on a parallel script and then
yeah,
come back.
Yeah, you do. You work. I mean, sometimes if you think that you've come to a point where it doesn't fall into place, you leave it. Dalai Paide was like that. It's a film which I had planned. Instead of Dil Se, which Rukh was, we had planned that, you know, and it just didn't fall into place, the end didn't fall into place. So we left it and went on to doing Dil Se. And the moment we finished, you know, Dil Se, Ali Paide fell into place.
First draft is always done by you?
Yeah, 100%. First and the last.
Okay. Uh-huh. What is the middle?
Middle is, sometimes I've worked with, you know, few writers which I've tried working with, you know, it's just a rapport that you get on.
Right.
But your response, it's your baby, you have to take care and, you know, it's very good even you have somebody like Sujata sir or Jay Mohan with you, you know, it's easy to get another brain, you know, ticking along with it. But it's the way you go that, you know, they were willing to let you lead.
At what point do you begin showing a draft to others?
Right. First, I mean, even before it is formed, I share it with the assistant director. You tell them this is an idea and you see what the reaction is. And sometimes when you're telling, it gets formed better. And then when you start writing, as soon as you write a bunch of scenes, you send it to the ADs and, you know, just they first have to do the spell correction, grammar correction, and then they have to give.
How do you ensure that they are giving you the right feedback and not in awe of Mani Ratnam and how can we tell him and that kind of stuff, you know?
I think the ADs are the difficult nuts to crack. I think they are the most difficult people to please. They will not say it's not good. They will not say it's not, you know, I mean, it's not bad. They will just keep quiet maybe. And you know, unless, you know, you get a very, very positive response, you know it's not working.
Has there been a film where you've not gotten a positive response and yet you said, okay, I think I'm convinced with this and I'm going to work ahead with it regardless of what you guys feel?
You have to go with your instinct, you know,
right.
I mean, that is what guides you, your filmmaking. If somebody has negative comments or somebody has critical comments about this one, what you take from that or what is already inside you, you know, it's in your mind but you've not, you know, acknowledged it or not faced it, you've just hidden it. But when somebody else points it, you're willing to, you take it and sort it out, you know. And sometimes, you know, the rest of the time where you think that they're looking at outside elements, you know, in terms of market, in terms of other things other than the, you know, basic plot of the film or the character of the film, then you take whatever you think is constructive to you and leave the rest.
One of the most treasured things for a filmmaker is a voice, and you have a very unique voice. While writing then, do you wonder if something is too Mani Ratnam-esque? I'm not talking about cliche, I'm talking about this is sounding a little too much like what I would do. Let's step back and try to rework it. Does that happen sometimes?
Yeah, all the time. Recently, I've finished Kaatru Veliyidai. There's so many moments where I said, no, it sounds like me. Even when I go to the shooting stage and we're trying to stage the scene, you know, we try to step away from it, you know, just that you make them say, and then you feel that it's too much like me, you know, and you try to reinvent it and make sure that it's closer to the person. That, you know, we try to bring more of the actors into it and make them, you know, own it a lot more. It's not only for the scenes, it is for everything, you know, I mean, it's for the shots, it's for the way we cut, you know, I mean, so you try to avoid things that you've done.
It is a Mani Ratnam movie that is still yours in a way. Now, how do you explain that? Is that yeah. because it comes from a place that's uniquely yours?
I don't know.
Yours?
I think you can have shades, you know. I mean, it can't be something which is totally out of me.
Okay.
It has to be me. Otherwise, there's no point. I'm making the film. I remember once when I was talking to Mohanlal when we were doing Irivar, you know. I mean, I've always been amazed at this man, you know. I mean, where in doing in Malayalam films is... where scripts are written last minute and scenes are still coming, he still gets one beautiful thread of a character, you know, so consistent. So I wondered whether he listens to the name of the character and decides this person is like this, you know. And he had said one thing which was very, you know, beautiful. He says, I'm a goalkeeper. You kick the ball that way, I'll dive that way. You kick it this way, I'll dive this
way. Wonderful.
So it is so true that it stayed with me. I mean, and that's what we try to do. You know, if the film and the characters go in a particular fashion, we try to get ourselves there. You have to be there. But still, you'll have to be in that position and not in your original position and try to hold it.
Do you enjoy the writing process more or the directing process more? Do you find it hard to let go of the writer in you? And tomorrow, if someone gave you a great script, would it interest you to be a pure director in that film?
I love it. I really love it. The writing is the most difficult thing. And you're still writing even when you're making a film. I would love to just concentrate on this. But that will mean that I'll have to take the script and own it, you know, I mean, it has to become a part of me, it has to become my thinking process also. But I really would love it. It'll be a dream to have a full-bound script given by somebody which is perfect, you know. I mean.
So are you saying in 30-plus years, you've not got one bound script that interested you?
No, but maybe I've shut doors also, you know, maybe
okay.
I'm not letting people, maybe I'm too, you know, not opening up enough. Maybe, but it will really be a pleasure to have a full script and, you know, be able to.
Since you've been a writer-director for over 30 years now, when you write, do you already direct the scene in your head? Do you already see a certain kind of a shot placement? Do you already hear a certain kind of background music when you're doing it?
For you, that line is kind of, you know, is an invisible line.
Right.
Your some scenes form, you know, with the geography, with the kind of a kind of a rhythm with which it will be shot as you're right. But some scenes are not yet written fully, perfectly till you're shooting. So, you know, the writer moves in along with the director and the director is there when your writing is also. So it's not a clear line. And nowadays it moves on to the editing too, you know. It just doesn't stop. The writer keeps coming even there, you know. Editing has become an extension of writing. It becomes actually the final draft,
right. Actually.
So you're still polishing not only the way it's shot, the way it's cut, but also the way it is written, you know. I mean, if some lines are weak, you're still trying to see whether you can get away from them and make it more honest, take away whatever is false or whatever is Mani Ratnam-esque, you know, take them away out of the film.
Why are you saying whatever is false is Mani Ratnam-esque?
No, whatever is false, stroke.
Slash. Okay. You often say that the script is a blueprint and then you kind of, your job, a director's job is to make the script come alive. Are you saying that you leave the script a little incomplete so that it allows you to find the magic, or do you have it complete because in case you don't find the magic, you still have a basic?
I mean, you should have the script complete. There's no doubts about it. But that is just on the table. So from the complete script, you try to find a film out of it. You know, you're just not translating the script into film, but you're trying to find a film out of that. You find reality or find life in that. So it is a completely different exercise altogether. But you have to have, if nothing works, you know that you will not fall down, that there is a base. that there is a minimal that the script can give you.
So for instance, in that Irivar scene, if you hadn't gotten that location where one was on top and one below, you could have still had
the scene would have still worked.
Okay.
We would have staged it in a way. I had two very good actors. It would have still worked. This okay. just adds dynamism to the entire thing. Okay. Voice becomes, you have to throw, you have to shout. All that, no, not just the visual, also the audio gets a different perspective completely.